What's happening, martial arts friends? Nick here. In today's video, I have an awesome training drill. Wait, scratch that. I have three awesome training drills that'll help you and your training partners with your kata memory. And we're getting started right now. All right, if that intro is a little bit confusing, good. The whole idea, not just for this video, but the whole video series, is to confuse you a little bit, throw a curveball at your normal way of training your katas, make them a little bit more exciting, a little bit more fun, but also help you retain the information a little bit better than just constantly repeating the same motions in the same way. So this is actually video number 5 in that series. When we first started, we weren't sure how many we would do, but we've been getting a lot of submissions in from people all over with some awesome ideas, and since the whole point of this whole channel is to not just share my ideas, but to share everybody's ideas that will help anybody else improve their training, I wanna make sure that we bring you every little bit that we possibly can. And we're gonna keep it going for as long as you guys keep showing interest. So if you like this stuff, give a thumbs up, drop a comment down below, let me know that you like this, and we'll keep going with it. Also, make sure you hit subscribe. That way you won't miss all of our upcoming ones. But with that, let's go ahead and jump into this drill. All right, so like I mentioned in the intro, we have actually three different training drills that we'll talk about today. And the idea is that they kind of are a progression to each other. So the first one we start off with is gonna be the easiest, and they move up from there as far as difficulty. Now the first two will also be individual drills, ones you can do by yourself without anybody else around. And the third one is gonna be more of a partner drill or a group drill. So you can either run it in a class or if you're just working with a partner. All right, I'd like to give a quick shout out to a good friend of mine, Jason Kifer, for giving me the idea for the third one we'll talk about today. Jason's a longtime school owner, and he created things like Superstar for Life, which is a character development program with tons of social proof, and then beltstripes.com, which is a fantastic alternative to electrical tape, where you can get either custom or stock belt stripes that are super professional looking, but not sponsored by him at all. Just wanna give a shout out and a thank you to him. Now these three drills that we're talking about today, I like to refer to as a roundabout kata drill, because the whole idea is that we're just changing it and we're turning the person around and making them go in different directions. So the first drill that we're talking about is the most basic version of this. So if I normally do my kata facing towards the front of the room every time, all that we're gonna do is we're gonna turn them and they're gonna face sideways or backwards. This one's really simple, but especially with kids, it makes it very confusing because they might be used to turning towards, let's say, the bags or the windows or the mirrors or whatever you have. They're gonna use those as reference points for the entire kata. So doing it in a different direction will just help them learn it a little bit more thoroughly. Now the second drill that we're gonna talk about is very similar to the first one, but it's actually a lot more difficult. So with this one, instead of facing straight forward or to the left or the right or the back, I'm gonna take my kata and I'm gonna face over at a diagonal. So with this, the whole idea, just like all of our katas, we wanna start and stop in the same position. So if I start off this way and I wound up facing forward, I know that I was stepping based on the walls rather than stepping based on how the kata is supposed to step. So if I am back here like this and I'm turning around towards this direction for Heian Shodan, if I were to face off at an angle, so let's say I face towards this back wall here, like this, I'm gonna wind up facing over at another angle, which will actually throw us off quite a bit because we're used to turning and stepping our foot right towards a wall. Where this one, I actually have to get the motion down where I'm stepping into the correct position rather than just stepping based on a visual reference. All right, so the third and final drill that we're talking about is the one that I mentioned that we'll either do as a partner drill or as a group drill with an entire class. All right, so the idea is that at any point during my kata, so normally it's every like 3 to 5 motions, the person running the drill is gonna stop the person doing kata and change the direction that they're facing. So this makes it incredibly difficult because your reference points are always changing. So if I'm standing this way in Yoi and I go into Heian Shodan and I get stopped right here and I'm normally going to the right and they face me towards the front of the room, I need to know that I'm going to my left and continue my kata that way. So this makes it incredibly difficult. Difficult, yeah. So this makes it incredibly difficult for the person doing the kata to constantly process where they are in the actual form and where they need to go next, not based on any sort of reference point, but what the kata is supposed to do in general. Now you can either make this totally open where the person can be faced in any direction at all, whether it be a diagonal, to the left, behind them, anywhere like that, or you can just have the person in charge of saying change and make the person rotate, let's say clockwise every time. So they might turn 90 degrees every single time that person says change. And this will just make it a little bit more consistent, a little bit less confusing to start, and then move up from there if you want.
Change. Change.
But no matter how you train it, just have fun. Use your creativity to change it for yourself. And then make sure you toss a comment below with your thoughts on this drill, any other drills that you like to do. And then make sure you click the subscribe and the bell icon so you won't miss anything. And then check out some of the other videos I'll toss over on the side. Let me know if you have any questions, any video requests, or just want to say hi. Love to connect with everybody down there. Have an awesome time training this and a great day. See you in the next video. All right, peace.